Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the solution and discussion of gate question paper in mechanical engineering subject. And this is lecture number 43. We are going to discuss the solution for the questions from the subject fluid mechanics. And in this lecture, we take the questions from the fluid properties and we will solve. Question number, first question from 1995 question paper, gate question paper. A fluid is said to be Newtonian fluid when the shear stress is directly proportional to the velocity gradient, inversely proportional to the velocity gradient, independent of the velocity gradient, none of the above. So, the Newtonian fluid, shear stress. So, this is the velocity gradient du by dy and this is the shear stress. And for Newtonian fluid, so the answer is directly proportional to the velocity gradient answer. So, this is a linear relationship between the velocity gradient and the shear stress. So, it is directly proportional to the velocity gradient. This is the answer to the question. The next question from 1996 question paper, a fluid is one which can be defined as a substance, has same shear stress at all points, can deform indefinitely under the action of smallest shear force, has a small shear stress in all directions, is practically incompressible. The correct answer is the definition of the fluid. The fluid can deform indefinitely under the action of even a smallest shear force. That is the correct answer to the question. Next question also from 1996 question paper. The dimensions of surface tension. So, m l to the power minus 1, l square t to the power minus 1, m l to the power minus 1, t to the power minus 1, m t to the power minus 2. So, the surface tension, the unit for surface tension is the force per unit length. The unit is newtons per meter. The dimensions of newton and meter. So, for newton, it is kilogram meter by second square divided by meter in meter. So, this is kilogram per second square. So, simplifying, this will be kilogram per simple square, second square. So, for kilogram, it is mass m, second square, t to the power minus 2. So, it comes to numerator, t to the power minus 2. So, the correct answer is m, t to the power minus 2. The surface dimensions of surface tension is m, t to the power minus 2. The next question from 1997 question paper, the dimension of surface tension. Newtons per meter square, joules per meter square, watts per meter. The surface tension is also defined as the surface energy per unit area, joules per meter square or newton meter per meter square. Joules is newton meter and divided by meter square and it is newton per meter. So, force per unit area. So, the correct answer is joules per meter square. Surface tension is in joules per meter square. Next question from 1999 question paper, if P is the gauge pressure with a spherical drop within a spherical droplet, then the gauge pressure within the bubble of the same fluid and of the same size will be P by 4, P by 2, P and 2P. So, this is the droplet, this is the bubble of same size with the same fluid. So, for the droplet has one surface area whereas the bubble will have two surface layers. So, pressure of the bubble is equal to 2 times of pressure of the droplet. So, this will be answer is 2P. So, the pressure inside the bubble is 2 times the pressure inside the droplet of same size. Next question from 1999 question paper. The kinematic viscosity of air is 20 degrees Celsius at 20 degrees Celsius is given to be 1.6 in 10 power minus 5 meter square per second. Its kinematic viscosity at 70 degrees Celsius will be varying approximately. The answer is 2.2 10 power minus 5 meter square per second, 1.6 10 power minus 5 meter square per second, 1.2 10 power minus 5 meter square per second or 3.2 10 power minus 5 meter square per second. So, the temperature at 20 degrees Celsius, it is 1.6 in 10 power minus 5 meter square per second. What is the kinematic viscosity of air at the 70 degrees Celsius? This is the question. The correct answer is 2.2 10 power minus 5 meter square per second. So, we will see how in the next slide. So, the density of the air, it is varying. So rho, it is varying by rho equal to rho into 1 minus b into t. So where b is 1 by 273. So the volume coefficient of expansion 1 by the temperature. So rho 20 divided by rho 70. So rho, so substituting for temperature. So rho 20 by rho 70 equal to 1 minus 20 divided by 273 divided by 1 minus 70 divided by 270 equal to 1.246. So the ratio of density at 20 degree Celsius and 70 degree Celsius. Then similarly, absolute viscosity mu equal to mu o plus alpha t minus beta t square. So where mu o is 1.7 10 power minus 5, these are all the constant. Alpha equal to 5.6 10 power minus 8, beta equal to 0.1189 in 10 power minus 9. And similarly, mu 20 we calculate. So mu 20 equal to 1.8072 in 10 power minus 5 and mu 70 equal to 2.0337 in 10 power minus 5. So the mu 70 by mu 20 equal to 1.125. So substituting the values, it will be 1.125. Now the kinematic viscosity, mu 70 equal to mu 70 by mu 20 into rho 20 by rho 70 into mu 20. So substituting 1.26 into 1.125 into 1.6 in 10 power minus 5 equal to 2.24 in 10 power minus 5 meter square per second. This is the answer to the question. Next question from 2001 question paper, the SI unit of kinematic viscosity. So it is very simple, meter square per second. So meter square per second is the kinematic, is the unit for the kinematic viscosity that you have to remember. Then 2004 question, an incompressible fluid of kinematic viscosity 7.4 in 10 power minus 7 meter square per second and specific gravity 0.88 is held between two parallel plates. If the top plate is moved with a velocity of 0.5 meters per second while the bottom one is held stationary, the fluid attains a linear velocity profile in the gap of 0.5 millimeter between the plate. The shear stress in Pascal on the surface of the bottom plate equal to 65.1 Pascal, 0.651 Pascal, 6.51 Pascal, 651 Pascal. The answer is 0.651 Pascal or Newtons per meter square. So we will see how in the next slide. So kinematic viscosity is given 7.4 in 10 power minus 7 meter square per second. Specific gravity is given 0.88. So density of the fluid equal to 1000 into specific gravity. So 88 kilogram per meter cube. Velocity is given as 0.5 meters per second. And distance between the plate is 0.5 millimeter, which is 0.5 in 10 power minus 3 meter. From Newton's law of viscosity, shear stress tau equal to mu into du by dy. So mu equal to nu into rho. So we are not given absolute viscosity, we are given kinematic viscosity at the density. So we calculate mu equal to nu into rho into velocity by distance. So 1.4 in 10 power minus 7 into 880 into 0.5 divided by 0.5 in 10 power minus 3 equal to 0.651 Pascal. This is the answer to the problem. Next question from 2006 question paper, for Newtonian fluid, shear stress is proportional to the shear strain. Rate of shear stress is proportional to the shear strain. Shear stress is proportional to the rate of shear strain. And rate of shear stress is proportional to the rate of shear strain. So the answer is, from Newton's law of viscosity, shear stress is proportional to du by dy. So du by dy is the velocity gradient. So the answer is, shear stress is proportional to the rate of shear strain. The next question from 2014 question paper, the difference in pressure in newtons per meter square across an air bubble of diameter 0.001 meter immersed in water with a surface tension 0.072 newtons per meter is dash. So we are given the surface tension and the diameter of the bubble, air bubble. We have to calculate the pressure difference across the air bubble. So bubble diameter is 0.001 meter, surface tension sigma equal to 0.71 newton per meter. So difference in pressure delta P equal to 4 sigma by D equal to 4 into 0.072 divided by 0.001 equal to 288 newtons per meter square. So the answer is 288 newtons per meter square. Next question from 2016 question paper, assuming constant temperature condition and the air is to be an ideal gas, the variation in atmospheric pressure with the height calculated from the fluid statics is linear, exponential, quadratic and cubic. The answer is exponential. So So the variation of atmospheric pressure with the height is exponential. So we will see how, we will explain how in the next slide. So we know dP equal to minus rho g dz. So the change in pressure equal to rho g into change in the height. The for constant temperature, rho equal to pressure by constant. So for constant temperature condition, the density equal to pressure by a constant. So dP equal to minus P by C into G into dz. So rearranging dP by P equal to minus C. So C is a constant. So 1 by C is another constant into G into dz. Integrating this equation, logarithmic of P equal to minus of logarithmic of G C G z plus a constant A. A is the constant of integration. So taking, removing the logarithm, so this will be P equal to exponential e to the power minus C G z plus logarithmic of A is another constant A. So the function is exponential. So the pressure varies exponentially. So that is the answer to the problem. So the pressure in the atmospheric condition for constant temperature, it varies exponentially. Next question, Newton's law of viscosity states that the shear stress in the fluid is proportional to the velocity of the fluid, the time rate change of velocity of the fluid, rate of change of velocity of the fluid with the height of the fluid film, the square root of velocity of the fluid. So the Newton's law of viscosity, shear stress proportional du by dy, the answer is rate of change of velocity. So the shear stress is proportional to the rate of change of velocity of the fluid with the height of the fluid film. So du is the change of velocity, dy is the thickness of the fluid film. So it is proportional to, shear stress proportional to du by dy. Next question, a cubic block of side L and mass M is dragged over an oil film across a table by a string connects to the hanging block of mass M as shown in the figure. So this is the plunger, and here we have a mass, and this is the block which is pulled by the mass here. So there is a height of oil. So there is a layer of oil of height H of the oil of viscosity mu. The Newtonian oil film thickness is H. H is the height of the oil film with a viscosity mu, and the flow condition is laminar. The acceleration due to gravity is G, and the steady state velocity is V of the block. So the steady state velocity V of the block. So we have to calculate what is the V, velocity of the V of the block. So there is a metal block of mass M, and there is a string connected to your mass small m. So this is the mass small m. So this mass small m is pulling down. So this is the G is the acceleration due to gravity, and the metal block is sliding over a oil film of thickness H of the oil of viscosity mu, and the velocity we have to calculate. So velocity is given by capital M G H divided by mu L square, or M capital M G H by mu, or M G H by mu L square, or M G H by mu. So the correct answer is mgh by mu L square. So m is the mass of the weight, g is the acceleration due to gravity, h is the height, thickness of the oil film, mu is the absolute viscosity, L is the block, the cubical block of side of the cubical block, L square. So we will see how in the next slide. So this is the arrangement once again. So the Newton's law of viscosity, shear stress equal to mu into du by dy, so mu into v by h. So the area of the cube is L square. So F equal to A into mu into v by h. So the force equal to A into mu into v by h. So F equal to M into G. So M into G equal to A equal to L square mu into v by h. So velocity v equal to mgh divided by mu L square. So that is the answer to the problem. Next question from 2007 question paper, oil in a hydraulic cylinder is compressed from initial volume 2 meter cube to 1.96 meter cube. If the pressure of the oil in the cylinder changes from 40 megapascal to 80 megapascal during the compression, the bulk modulus of elasticity of the oil is dash. So which is, there are 4 options, 1000 megapascal, 2000 megapascal, 4000 megapascal and 8000 megapascal. So the answer is 2000 megapascal. So we will see how. So initial volume V1 equal to meter cube, final volume V2 equal to 1.96 meter cube, initial pressure P1 equal to 40 megapascal. final pressure P2 equal to 80 MPa. The bulk modulus of elasticity of the oil is given by K equal to P2 minus P1 divided by minus of dou V by V1. So, dou V by V1 equal to minus of V2 minus V1 divided by V1. So, substituting all the numerical values, 80 minus 40 divided by minus of 1.96 minus 2 divided by 2. So, calculating it is 2000 MPa. Next question from 2008 question paper. A general bearing has a shaft diameter of 40 millimeter and a length of 40 millimeter. The shaft is rotating at 20 radians per second and the viscosity of the lubricant is 20 millipascal second. The clearance is 0.02 millimeter. The loss of torque due to the viscosity of the lubricant is approximately 0.04 newton meter, 0.252 newton meter, 0.4 newton meter, 0.652 newton meter. So, the answer is 0.04 newton meter. So, we will see how in the next slide. So, diameter of the shaft 40 millimeter 0.04 meter, length of the shaft 40 millimeter 0.04 meter, angular speed omega equal 20 radians per second, viscosity of the lubricant mu equal 20 millipascal second, which is 0.02 pascal second, clearance, the height is 0.02 millimeter, which is 0.02 in 10 power minus 3 meter. So, loss of torque due to the viscosity of the lubricant. So, T equal to F into D by 2. So, where F equal to mu into pi dl into V by Y. So, V is the velocity, Y is the clearance of thickness of the oil film into D by 2. So, this is mu into pi dl, velocity equal to R into omega. So, R is the radius, omega is the angular velocity. So, velocity, linear velocity is equal to R into omega divided by Y into D by 2. Substituting all numerical values 0.02 into 3.14, pi is 3.14, 0.04 into 0.04 into R equal to 20 into 0.02 divided by 0.02 into 10 power minus 3. So, Y is also 0.02. So, 10 power minus 3 actually this is the Y distance value into 0.04 divided by 2, which is 0.04 newton meter. So, this is the answer to the problem. The loss of torque is 0.0204 newton meter. Next question from 2010 question paper. A lightly loaded full journal bearing has a journal diameter of 50 millimeter. The bush bore is 50.5 millimeter and the bush length is 20 millimeter. If the rotational speed of the journal is 1200 rpm and average viscosity of the liquid lubricant is 0.3 megapascal second, the power loss in watts will be 37 watts, 74 watts, 118 watts, 237 watts. The answer is 37 watts. So, we will see how in the next slide. So, bush bore, diameter of the bush equal to 50.5 millimeter, journal diameter is 50 millimeter, 0.05 meter, journal length equal to 20 millimeter, 0.02 meter, speed equal to 1200 rpm, viscosity of oil is mu equal to 0.3 pascal second. And the y equal to the clearance capital D minus small d divided by 2. So, thickness of the oil between the bush and the journal diameter. So, 50.5 minus 50 divided by 2 equal to 0.25 millimeter. So, velocity V equal to pi dn by 60. So, pi into 0.05 into 1200 divided by 60 equal to 3.14 radians per second. We calculate the torque. Torque T equal to F into D by 2. So, force into radius. So, mu into pi dl into capital V by Y, velocity by distance between clearance or the gap between the bush and the journal into D by 2. So, substituting numerical values, torque equal to 0.3 into pi into 0.05 into 0.02 into 3.14 divided by 0.25 into 10 power minus 3 into 0.05 divided by 2. So, which is 0.296 newton meter. So, the torque equal to 0.296 newton meter. Then we calculate the power loss. So, power loss equal to 2 pi nt by 60. So, 2 pi into 1200 into 0.0296 divided by 60 equal to 37.15 watts. So, the answer is power loss equal to 37 watts is the answer to the problem. The next question from 2014 question paper. In a simple concentric shaft bearing arrangement, the lubricant flows in the 2 millimeter gap between the shaft and the bearing. The flow may be assumed to be a plain Cauchy flow with zero pressure gradient. The diameter of the shaft is 100 millimeter and its tangential speed is 10 meters per second. The dynamic viscosity of the lubricant is 0.1 kilogram per meter second. The frictional resisting force per 100 millimeter length in the bearing is dash newton. So, we have to calculate the frictional resisting force. So we are given gap between the shaft and the bearing h equal to 2 millimeter, diameter of the shaft 100 millimeter 0.1 meter, length is 100 millimeter 0.1 meter, tangential speed 10 meters per second, and the viscosity of the oil 0.1 kilogram per meter second. So the frictional force F equal to mu A into V by H. So mu equal to 0.1 into pi dl. So pi into 0.1 into 0.1 into 10 divided by 0.002, which is 15.7 Newton. So the answer is 15.7 Newton. So the frictional resisting force in the arrangement is 15.7 Newton. Next question from 2015 question paper, which of the following statement is true when cavitation parameter sigma equal to 0? The total pressure is reduced to vapor pressure, cavitation starts, boiling of the liquid starts, cavitation stops. The answer is answer A, the point 1, 2, 3, they are correct, they are true. Answer B, only 2 and 3. Answer C, only 1 and 3. Answer D, only 1, 2 and 3. So the answer is 1, 2 and 3. So these are all the answer. So the how we will see how. So what is 1, 2, 3? When sigma equal to 0, the total pressure is reduced to vapor pressure, cavitation starts and boiling of the liquid starts. So these are all the phenomena of the cavitation. We will see how. Cavitation number is given by sigma equal to P minus PV divided by 1 by 2 rho V square. So V is where P is the vapor pressure, P is the pressure of the fluid. When sigma equal to 0, the total pressure is equal to vapor pressure, P equal to PV. The formation of vapor bubble will start, that is boiling occurs and cavitation will start. So the sigma, when sigma equal to 0, so the vapor pressure is equal to total pressure, there will be formation of bubble or boiling, and the cavitation will start in the cavitation area. The next question from 2016 question paper, consider a fluid flow between two infinitely horizontal plates which are parallel, the gap between them is 50 millimeter. The top plate is sliding parallel to the stationary bottom plate at a speed of 3 meters per second. The flow between the plate is slowly due to the motion of the top plate. The force per unit area required to maintain the bottom plate stationary is dash newtons per meter square. So viscosity of the fluid is 0.44 kilogram per meter second and density is 888 kilogram per meter cube. So the gap between plate y equal to 50 millimeter 0.05 meter, speed of the top plate is 3 meters per second, viscosity of the fluid mu equal to 0.44 kilogram per meter second. So the force per unit area required F equal tau equal to F by A, which is mu into V by Y. So 0.44 into 3 divided by 0.05 equal to 26.4 newtons per meter square. So the force per unit area required to maintain the bottom plate stationary is 26.4 newtons per meter square. So the answer is 26.4 newtons per meter square. Next question from 2018 question paper, a solid block of 2 kg mass slides steadily at a velocity V along a vertical wall as shown in the figure below. So this is the block is sliding with a velocity V. A thin oil film of thickness H equal to 0.15 millimeter provides lubrication between the block and the wall. So this is the 0.15 H equal to 0.15 millimeter. The surface area of the block in contact with the oil film is 0.04 meter square. The velocity distribution within the oil film has a linear relationship as shown in the figure. So we have the velocity distribution is linear. Take dynamic viscosity is 7 in 10 power minus 3 Pascal second and acceleration due to gravity is 10 meters per second square. Neglect the weight of the oil. The terminal velocity V in meters per second of the block is given by dash. So the correct to two decimal places. So this is 10.7 meters per second. We will see how in the next slide. So this is again the diagram. So we are given dynamic viscosity mu equal to 7 into 10 power minus 3 Pascal second and acceleration due to gravity g equal to 10 meters per second square. So from the Newton's law, shear stress equal to W by A. So W is the weight divided by A or force divided by A, which is also equal to mu by V by H. Now, the terminal velocity V in meters per second is equal to mu into V by H equal to W by A. So, V equal to W by A into H by mu. So, 2 into 10 2 into 10 divided by 0.04 is the area, and 2 into 10, this is the mass equal to 2 kilogram, and 10 is the acceleration due to gravity, h equal to 0.15 10 power minus 3, and a this mu equal to 7 into 10 power minus 3 equal to 10.714 meters per second. So, this is the answer, 10.7 meters per second. Next question from 2019 question paper, two immiscible incompressible viscous fluid have same densities but different viscosities are connected between the two infinite horizontal plates 2 meter apart as shown in below. The bottom plate is fixed and the top plate is moving to the right side with a constant velocity of 3 meters per second. With assumption of Newtonian fluid, steady and fully developed laminar flow with zero pressure gradient in all the directions, the momentum equation is simply d square u by dy square equal to 0. If the dynamic viscosity of the lower fluid is mu 2 is twice that of the upper fluid mu 1, then velocity of the interface is dash meters per second. So, these are all the two fluid, one first top, the fluid at the top layer is mu 1, density mu 1, viscosity mu 1, and the bottom layer of viscosity mu 2, and both layer of height 1 millimeter. So, mu 2 equal to 2 times of mu 1, that is the condition. The dynamic viscosity of the bottom fluid is 2 times of the kinematic dynamic viscosity of the top fluid. And the answer is 1 meters per second. So, we will see how. So, this is the arrangement once again. The total height is 2 meter and the mu 1, mu 2 are the dynamic viscosity of the two fluid. The relationship is mu 2 equal to 2 mu 1. Velocity of the upper part. So, the velocity here u equal to 3 meters per second. Velocity of the interface we take v and the velocity of the bottom layer equal to 0. So, bottom layer is stationary and in between we have the velocity v. The shear stress at this is the same at the interface of the two fluids. So, tau 1 equal to tau 2. So, tau 1 equal to tau 2. So, for tau 1, for the top layer, mu 1 into u minus v divided by h1 equal to mu 2 into v minus o, 0. So, because bottom layer is not moving, v minus 0 divided by h2. So, we have h1 equal to h2 equal to 1 meter. So, the height is equal to 1 meter. So, mu 1 into 3 minus v divided by 1 equal to 2 mu 1, because mu 2 equal to 2 times of mu 1 into v minus 0 by 1, simplifying 3 minus v. So, mu 1 is getting cancelled, 3 minus v equal to 2 times of v. So, v equal to 1 meters per second. That is the answer to the problem. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I have written in the mechanical engineering subject. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects and the gate question paper in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better preparation, and thanks for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. If you want lecture notes of any of the subjects mentioned here, you can comment on the comments box. I will, or you write to my mail ID, I will sincerely respond and share the notes with you for the subject mentioned in the previous slide. So, thank you. We will meet again with another video lecture on the solution of gate question paper in fluid mechanics.